May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and redeemer.
Amen.
In the book which I am currently reading, the theologian says, "No wonder it is easier for us to talk about our experiences than it is to talk about God. Easier to talk about the gospel's impact upon us than about the God who is revealed in the gospel. Our experience is tangible and concrete. God is mysterious, elusive, and transcendent." When I read these remarks, I wondered about our spiritual journeys in life. We claim we believe in God, and yet I, and perhaps many of us, often struggle to find words how to talk about God. God is mysterious, oftentimes elusive and transcendent, and that transcendent nature of God is difficult to comprehend. Last week, I thought about God as mysterious, elusive, and transcendent. I thought about our readings for today, and I tried to see how those readings were linked and what they revealed about God. The wonderful scholars, the formulators of our lectionary, intentionally linked the first reading with the gospel. And you can usually see that and hear that. There's an intentional link. And very often, there's a link even to the middle reading, the second reading. And preachers love that when it's that easy. What occurred to me in thinking about all three readings was one word which kept coming back to me. That word was not mysterious, elusive, or transcendent. That word was change. The prophet Jonah was commanded by God to preach change to the people of Nineveh. Paul challenged the Corinthians to change their ways of living in order to prepare for the second coming of Jesus. The Gospel of Mark tells us that Jesus called his disciples from the routines of their daily lives. Simon Peter, Andrew, James, and John were called from their work of fishing to follow. And follow they did. They radically changed the way they lived their lives in order to follow Jesus. Now, CNN or other national news organization were to have interviewed the people of Nineveh, the people from Corinth, or the first disciples, just what would they have discovered about change? What impact did change have on their lives, and would they be able to talk about God in light of having embraced change? More specifically, what might an interviewer have discovered about those first disciples of Jesus? He called them into service, and that call mandated change. Next Sunday, we will celebrate the annual meeting of the parish, a time-honored and beloved tradition in our church. It will be a time of celebration as we look back over the past year and peer already into the year that has begun. Our time together will be a time of reflecting on the goodness of God in our life here at St. Mark's. We will see and or hear reports which will contain information from just about every ministry of the parish. We will feast on chili and other delectable foods for lunch. We will hold elections for the vestry and delegates to convention, a fascinating exercise of the democratic polity of our tradition as Episcopalians. major part of our time together will be about parish finances, pledges, other monetary gifts, and financial resources which contribute to the budget for 2018. And oh, how wonderful it is that so many of us have generously pledged toward our life together in 2018, for which I and parish leadership are very grateful. For me, it will be my first annual meeting at St. Mark's. In preparation for my report, I reviewed my report that I gave this time last year at St. Peter's Episcopal Church in Cambridge, Massachusetts. That was my final report at St. Peter's, a parish which recently celebrated its 175th anniversary. Who knew apart from God what changes I would face from that report a year ago to the report I will read next week? Who knew the depth of change which would occur for me as I embraced God's call to serve here at St. Mark's and all that that call and response would entail? For any one of us who has moved a distance for a new job or a career change, change is a necessary aspect of life. Life is not static, it consistently moves. Some of us experience change as just simply part of life's journey. Others of us experience change as difficult, even in the best of circumstances. No matter what, change is simply part of life's journey. Some changes are good. Some other changes may be difficult and require work. I wonder if those first disciples who responded to Jesus' invitation to follow ever looked back. I wonder if they reflected on the change which they embraced, change which required strength and courage of commitment. To have walked away from one's livelihood, one's work, one's family, one's friends, surely required strength and commitment. Like them, strength and courage of commitment are important in our response to the invitation from Jesus to follow. So, what does it mean to follow? I could probably stop right there and give us some time to think about that. What does it mean to set aside some things in order to embrace other things? What does it mean to embrace change in order to follow and to experience the depth and breadth of God's love for us? I believe we are here this morning, instead of sipping coffee and reading the Wall Street Journal, to experience the love of God in Jesus and in one another. We are here because we are committed to be here, a commitment which just might enable us to experience the joy of knowing that when we are committed to God in Jesus, we are blessed. I frequently talk about the blessing of God's abundant grace in our lives, our individual lives, and our lives as a community of faith. I believe that that blessing, that grace, is there for us and is always there. It is up to us to pick that fruit from the tree of life, savor its sweetness, and make it work for us. When we say yes to the invitation to follow Jesus, we say yes to a world of wonder, love, and refreshment. We say yes to a relationship with God in Jesus and relationship to one another in this community of faith. This community of faith is strong in our commitment to walk in the footsteps of Jesus. We are strong in our determination to be more like him, to be more kind, more generous, more loving, and more accepting and respectful of others. For some of us, that's a walk in the park. For me, and perhaps for some of you, the needed change of mind and heart to be more like Jesus can be a challenge. Oh, enter the abundant grace of God. We are here today to be nourished and fed for the journey of acceptance. We are here as part of our acceptance to the invitation to follow Jesus. We are here to accept God's love in Jesus, a love which can transform us into people of justice, peace,